Good morning and welcome to Channing Memorial Church Unitarian Universalist. My name is Pam Eldenary. My pronouns are she, her, hers, and I'm a worship associate here at Channing. I'm joined today by our minister, the Reverend Jane Bennett Smith, and our music director, Stephen Deininger. What a joy it is to be here with all of you this morning and some new faces today. It's wonderful. Before we begin the service, I'd like to extend a special welcome to our visitors. We hope you find worship nourishing and that you'll stay to get to know us as we gather outside on the patio across the hall after the service. And we're happy to help you with any questions you may have. If you'd like more information about Channing Memorial Church, please send an email to welcome@channingmc.org, and that address appears in the order of service. Since the COVID risk level in our area is low at this time, masks are optional for this indoor service. If you'd like to participate in hymn singing, which we hope you will, we do ask that you mask for the duration of the hymn. And now we have an auction announcement from Miss Hannigan.
Well, hello there. I'm Agatha Hannigan, Miss Agatha Hannigan. I run this orphanage. You may be wondering why I'm gussied up a little today. A little bird told me that I'm about to meet Oliver Warbucks. The Oliver Warbucks, the gajillionaire. I was thinking we might hit it off. What do you think?
I think there's a good chance.
That little gutter snipe Annie always says, you're never dressed without a smile. Well, what does she know? I always think it doesn't hurt to have some other accessories when it comes to worming your way into someone's affections. Oh, I know, you're not interested in me and my accessories. You just keep coming here hoping to catch a glimpse of our little celebrity, Annie. Right now, precious Annie is on her knobby little knees, sprucing this place up until it shines like the top of the pipe organ at First Unitarian Baltimore. In other words, she's getting this place ready for the Channing auction. I know it's an online auction, but don't tell those kids just yet. The auction's only a week away, and they're as excited as you are. For you, that means a chance to have a grand old time while raising money for the church. For me, it means a chance to get this place cleaned up by those little girls within the next week. That reminds me, your auction team, and I heard Warbucks has another name for them. Your auction team asked me to pass on a few points of information. Number one, At 1 o'clock this afternoon, Eric Smith, the Eric Smith, will be holding tutorials over Zoom to help us get prepared to use Octrea for the silent auction and the sign-up genius for fixed price auction items. To get into the tutorial session, just use the usual Sunday service link on the Channing website. I'll be clicking the link because I'm in the market for some attractive accessories. And another thing from the auction team. You'll need to register or re-register on Octrea for the silent auction, even if you've registered in the past for some reason. See the email announcement for the link or contact the planning team at channingauction@yahoo.com. And another thing. The final auction catalog will be coming out and will be appearing in your email inbox, I don't know when, but word around the orphanage is soon. Now, since the live auction starts at 6 p.m., otherwise known as dinner time, you may be wondering if I'm going to supply you with food from the orphanage. The answer would either be no, or heck no. But if you'd like to order takeout food, there are two places you can pick from where you can have a little parking lot mingle with other Channing folks doing the same thing and pick up your coveted auction goodie bag. Just order on time to pick up your food on Saturday at 3:30 p.m. I repeat, order on time to pick it up by 3:30 p.m. at either Lito's Pizza or Nora's Kebab, both on Route 40 in Ellicott City. Lito Pizza or Nora's Kebab. That's all I've got. The auction planning team says thank you. And I say, if you see Annie, tell her to get back to work.
Thank you, Miss Hannigan.
Back to work.
Now, let us prepare to enter sacred time.
Blessed is the ground on which we stand. Holy is this place. Holy are the pieces of memory, the places which have formed us, where we store the icons of success and shattered dreams, and gather threads and pieces of what would become. Holy are the places of memory. Holy are the places of the dream, the places over the rainbow where all children are wanted, and all people are fed, where colors are the source of celebration and youth and age come to the table as one. Holy are the places of the dream. Holy are the places of change and pain, the places of our struggle where the rivers of our lives run white and fast, and we hold on, and grow. Holy are the places of change and pain. Holy are the places of connection, the places where we risk ourselves, where hands, touch souls, touch minds. And in awareness too, we change our lives. Holy are the places of connection. Holy are the places of becoming, the places of clear vision where life and world are intertwined, and we can see forever in this moment and give thanks. Holy are the places of becoming. Blessed is the ground on which we stand. Holy and whole making is this place. Come, let us worship together. I invite you to rise in body or in spirit and join me in singing When We Are Gathered.
Please remain standing as Lynn Schaefer lights our chalice. We light this chalice in honor of first steps, for beginning, even when the path ahead is unclear, for the courage it takes to trust that the way will reveal itself, that light will come to clarify our vision, that friends will be by our side. May the words, song, stillness, and common breath of this hour remind us that every step of the way is never one we take alone.
Okay, it's time for our story for all ages. I see you're already up front. Do you want to come? Do you want to come sit or do you want to stay in your chair? You're going to stay in the chair. Good choice. It's comfier. Okay. How are you doing this morning? Good. How are you? Doing well? You excited for a story about a caterpillar? Okay. Thank you. Thank you for that. All right. I don't know if it happened this way, but I do know that it is true. That long ago and far away, or more likely recently and quite nearby, high up in the mountains on a black cherry tree, an egg was laid on a leaf. And in the light of the full moon, out of that egg hatched a little brownish caterpillar with white markings that would look to any bird who might chance to come by, perhaps like bird droppings. The caterpillar's name was Homer. Homer looked around in surprise and wonder to find himself alive in the world. Better eat your egg casing, little friend, said a black and spiky caterpillar nearby. Homer did just that and then turned to look at his new friend. Welcome to the world, said the caterpillar, whose name was Alex. It's delicious. Here, try some of this leaf. Together, the two caterpillars munched on leaves that spring through rain and sun,
sun rises and sun sets. They laugh together at the antics of baby birds and hid together under leaves that the black spiky caterpillar had collected so that parent birds could not catch them. Alex taught Homer all he needed to know about living on the leaf, how to stay safe, how to munch, how to enjoy the feeling of the wind stirring the tree and the sun slowly warming the mountains each morning. Together, they gaze each night up.